In this video, I will show you how I get AdSense approval on my one-month-old website, with less than 20 posts and very little organic traffic. These are the contents I am going to share, including details about my blog, such as the topic chosen and number of posts I have on my blog, etc. Minimum requirement to get AdSense approval. Time taken for AdSense to review my website. I'm also going to show you how I fix policy violations on my website, such as valuable inventory no content and under construction issues. If you like this video and want to hear more about the ways to monetize your website and getting AdSense approval fast, make sure you give this video a like and subscribe my YouTube channel. I will pick one subscriber who comment here to receive my monetized blog free when my channel hit 1,000 subs and 4,000 hours view. Make sure you don't miss this chance. Anyways, let's dive right into it. Let me have a brief introduction on my AdSense status at that time. Few months ago, I got two blogs approved by Google AdSense. These blogs were set up on Blogger platform, and I shared some actuarial science and financial stuffs there. My first blog, written in Chinese, was approved by AdSense in March 2021. Soon after that, I created an English blog and it was approved in April. I will focus on the AdSense approval process of my English blog. Why don't I start with my first blog? Well, that story might take me an hour to explain, and it was quite complicated because there were tons of issues involved, such as policy violations, duplicate account detected and closing AdSense account. In case this topic is getting popular, I will discuss more AdSense story of my first website in my future YouTube videos. Are you ready? The process from my blog creation to getting AdSense approval within a month start now. On March 23, 2021, I created my English blog right after AdSense approved my Chinese blog. Since there were lots of content in my Chinese blog, so I just translated and posted them on my new blog. At first, I uploaded one post day by day, and there was a total of 5 posts. 4 of them related to finance, and the last post was used to record my AdSense application in this blog. Then I submitted these URLs to Google Search Console and update my sitemap to index these posts. I also created these important pages, but the format was a bit distinguished with others. I will explain it later. 1 week later, I submitted my first AdSense application after these posts were indexed by GSC. Apparently, it was impossible to get any approval with only 5 posts. I was rejected by Google AdSense on the evening of April 7th with an email sent to my mailbox. It showed that I need to fix some issues before my site is ready for AdSense. For the specific details of these issues, you have to check through AdSense dashboard. AdSense stated that my blog has 2 issues. As what I have mentioned in beginning, these 2 issues were no content issue and under construction issue. I didn't notice the second issue when I checked AdSense dashboard on my phone. How should I know I have to scroll down to see the next issue? Now you should remember this if you are still new to AdSense. So I uploaded 8 actuarial science posts that I had translated before I received any update from AdSense. I did not upload it as soon as I finished my translation, because I want to estimate the minimum number of posts for my blog to be eligible for AdSense. Before I used my laptop to submit next application at the same night, I just noticed the under construction issue shown on my AdSense dashboard. I removed some unused search pages with labels. Those labels were not appeared in all my posts. I think this was where the issue came from. And then I submitted my application again after I simply reviewed my blog, so this was my second attempt. Meanwhile, I translated and uploaded another 3 AS posts when I was still waiting for any reply from AdSense. On morning of April 11th, AdSense updated my application status, and there were some improvements this time. No content issue was fixed, but under construction issue still remained. At that moment, I had a total of 16 posts, but I could not find any problems related to under construction issue. I was busy with other things after that morning, and I reviewed back my blog again on evening. After I'd done an in-depth inspection on my website, I found some broken links in some of the oldest posts, so I repaired them within a short period of time. Then, I submitted my third application to AdSense on night. 1 week later, there was no update or any reply from AdSense. During that period, I wrote another 3 posts, and I shared one of them to a local website forum. It is like a financial theme Reddit in my country, and I received around 1,000 views from that post. Most of them were referral traffic. Few days later, I received a reply from Google AdSense. On April 21st around 5 p.m., my blog was approved by AdSense. I was not sure why it took 10 days to review and approve my blog, but I was still happy to get AdSense approval for my blog within a month. The process for my website to get AdSense approval ends here. Let me summarize some key moments during my new blog's AdSense application process between March and April. I created this blog on March 23rd and got the AdSense approval on April 21st with 3 attempts. Coincidentally, both of my blogs were approved by AdSense around 5 p.m. I wasn't sure why it was, maybe it was just coincident. My blog was newly created with just 1 month old, the views shown on my blogger dashboard at that moment was around 3,200. About 95% of these views were referral or direct traffic, and organic traffic just contributed less than 5% here. This was all real, I can't just fake a story and making it into a YouTube video just to trick you. All I want to do is just sharing my personal experience about how I get AdSense approval on my website with less than 20 posts and little organic traffic in a month. So if you really think this information is quite useful, you may leave a like and subscribe this YouTube channel. Let me know if you all want to know more about AdSense. I will make more video about it if this video is getting popular. Back to the topic, I will briefly go through with the issues I met on my website that was getting pointed out by AdSense. And I will explain what I have done to fix these issues completely and eventually get AdSense approval. These issues are valuable inventory, no content, and valuable inventory, under construction. No content issue means the website has insufficient posts. This issue is quite straightforward and it can be fixed by publishing more high-quality contents. High quality here means the content is original, not directly copied or scrapped from other side, useful and informative to your readers. Written in well-organized structure and good grammar. With few images added between paragraphs. I have 16 posts on my blog when no content issue was fixed, so I estimate the minimum number of posts should be around 15 to 20 posts, and definitely it should be more than 5 posts. Each of my posts has around 500 to 1200 words, average at 800. Do not just write your posts with less than 500 words, AdSense probably will not accept your application if your posts are too short. For your information, these posts have to be indexed by Google Search Console, or else no matter how many posts you write, no content issue will still exist and AdSense will reject your site. Next, under construction issue means somewhere on the website is unnecessarily difficult or frustrating to navigate or interact with. This includes pages or apps that are under construction, not functioning, or lead to error messages. At first, I removed some label search page on menu bar that I transfer from my old blog's layout. For example, I did not use this label in my new blog, so I think this was what AdSense called not functioning. Therefore, don't try to make this mistake like me. I was able to completely fix under construction issue on my blog by checking all the links showed in the posts or pages carefully. You have to ensure these links are correct and not broken, any broken link should be fixed. For my website, few links in two of my posts were considered to be confused to users who click them. These links should redirect my users to the correct site, a local bank website, but they redirect my users to Blogger Edit page, which is also the Blogger login page. I finally got AdSense approval for my blog after I fixed this issue by replacing the broken links. So these were what I have done to solve my blog's issues. Since I encountered them only during this AdSense application, I can't give my opinion on other issues here. But you may refer to AdSense Help Center for other issues such as low-value content and navigation issue. For the pages, I only focus on About Me and Contact page. Other pages such as Disclaimer, Terms and Conditions and Privacy Policy are slightly less important from my perspective. Basically, I wrote these pages briefly with a Google Documents link inside. You can see what I have done to these pages here. So this is how I set up them and still get AdSense approval. I did also saw some blogger who didn't have these pages, but still approved by AdSense. About Me and Contact page are considered important, you have to show your credibility and provide a communication channel to your users. For About Me page, I wrote it like my resume with academic details such as my degree and qualifications etc. Especially for those blogs under YMYL, Your Money Your Life, About Me with specific details is important. AdSense is going to reject you anyway if you fail to do so. I will summarize my 8 important points to get AdSense approval. First, all contents should be original, high quality and informative. Second, no scrapped content is allowed. Third, each post should have about 500 to 1,200 words. Fourth, there should be at least 15-20 posts on your blog. Fifth, there is no requirement on traffic, I got 95% referral traffic when AdSense approved my blog. Make sure you don't purchase any traffic or bots, AdSense is smart to detect your unusual activities. Sixth, there is also no requirement on the timing. I got my AdSense approval within a month from my blog's creation. Seventh, set up important pages, especially about me and contact page. Lastly, set up and connect your website with Google Search Console and Google Analytics. Update your sitemap and submit your links to GSC to index your posts. This is the end of the explanation part of this video. The following content is showing most of the evidence from my blog creation to AdSense approval. You may see how I did it, and maybe you can see what I have done in details to finally get AdSense approval. You may leave your questions down here, maybe I can provide some suggestion to you. Before that, make sure you leave a like and subscribe my YouTube channel to get more tutorials and my personal experience on Google AdSense. Hope you can get your AdSense approval as soon as possible. Thank you.